Next topic we'll talk about is agency theory. Although I think I have elaborated and discussed in detail what is the principal-agent relationship, but just to, you know, rush through this, we'll talk about agency theory in detail. Basically, agency relationship refers to a situation wherein one party is delegating some work to another party. So there's a principal and there's an agent. So agency theory attempts to explain two problems: conflict between the management and owner's interest, which is created because of separation of ownership and control, because the owners of the company are different and managers of the company are different. An agency problem can arise from conflicts between controlling and non-controlling shareholders. So there's a principal, there can be agents, and there's some task. So agents are supposed to perform some task on behalf of the principal, and their accountable agents are accountable to principal or shareholders with respect to how much work they have done. So to make sure that the agent is not keeping his self-interest first rather than the interest of the shareholders or the organization as such, companies incur a lot of cost. That is known as cost of agency relationship. If you're going to delegate your work, so one thing is that you do your work on your own. But many a times it's not possible for people to do their work on their own because they're occupied at various other places. So if you assign your work to somebody else, you employ someone else to do your work. In that case, monitoring is very important so that the other person is doing it in the right letter and spirit of the thing, as well as he's not wasting the resources, he's optimally utilizing it and trying to achieve the objective which you have set for him. So agency cost occurs largely from principal's monitoring activities of agent, which may be viewed in terms of money, resources consumed, or time taken in monitoring. For example, you know, board of directors, they have the decision to fix up salaries for everyone. Now, board of directors can themselves decide that, you know, we will give ourselves maximum salaries, or they can, you know, decide on their own that whatever salaries they want to give. How does shareholder or the owner of the company ensures that the board of directors do not take unnecessary salaries or ingenuine salaries to themselves? So for that purpose, in the code of corporate governance, there are it is compulsory that there has to be a remuneration committee. So there will be a committee only who will keep, although those committee will include board of directors only, but at least there will be, those committee members will be answerable to fix up salaries for everybody. So little bit of transparency, and then these salaries need to be disclosed in the annual report of the company. So if you want to know what is the salary of any company's CEO, just download the annual report and read it. The salary of the CEO and the board of directors is mentioned over there. So that is how transparency is tried to be maintained, so that nobody is eating away the fund of the organization just because they keep their self-interest more as compared to the company's interest. Similarly, cost of principal is, the principal spends a lot of money reviewing annual report data, and cost of management providing this data, such as committee activity, risk management analysis, getting the audit done. So there is cost which the principal is incurring for meeting with shareholders, financial analysts. So all these are kind of costs which the company incurs. Whenever there is some kind of, you know, conflict which arises, so that needs to be resolved. And there can be committees which can be formed. So when the shareholders' activities and market mechanisms are not enough to monitor the company, then some form of regulation is required. Apart from that, there can be many other measures of solving agency problems. For example, company can have meetings between key institutional investors and directors so that directors or employees can be told about, you know, what is the real purpose of the company, and they cannot misuse the funds or resources of the company like that. Voting rights at the AGMs, the annual general meetings which are held in support off certain resolutions. So these can also be mechanisms how, in case there is any conflict which arises, that can be resolved.